So let's say you found a font that looks great on a bunch of different screen resolutions and different sizes, and even better, it doesn't detract from the overall theme of your app. How would you use it? So here's a small app that I did to show you the different typographical sizes that are available in Android and their names. Now, right now, they're all using the Roboto font. Let's go and change that. So here's the app that we were just looking at. So if you want to add your own font, the first thing that you'll need to do is add an assets directory under source main. And we've included our font, which is Courgette Regular. It was just a font that I found on Google Web Fonts because most of them are available with open source licenses. So if we switch over to the Android view, it'll show up as assets and res directory, but those are the same location. So you might see one or the other depending on how you set up your Android Studio. If you're using your font inside of a fragment, due to the fragment lifecycle, you need to instantiate the typeface in the onAttach method. The reason for this is there's a short period of time after a fragment is created, but before it's attached to a host activity. So if you can see in this typeface create from asset function, we have get activity and then get assets. If this is called before it's attached to the activity, it will result in an error. So if we go to our onCreate method, after instantiating our text views, we just call the setTypeface function with the object that we just created. So if we look at this on a device, we can see that our display for and our headline view have changed. So this is our display for here, and then if we scroll up a bit, right here is our headline.